Chelsea.
Hey, good to see you.
Good to see you again. Thanks for coming to my office.
Sure thing.
You've bailed us out many times in the past. I'm going to need your help again. So we're rolling out our new application, and I've got some key requirements that have to be met.
Okay.
These are non-negotiable. The first thing is, this is going to affect all of our regions, all of our stores. What I'd like to do is at 9 o'clock in the morning, do a rollout in every region, starting right here in DC, moving through to the West Coast, and then eventually back to Europe. So this is going to be located everywhere.
Okay, got it.
Make sense? Mm-hmm. Okay, second thing is, partly because of that, partly because of the nature of the application, this is not like our legacy systems. We get no maintenance windows, we get no batch windows. I know you guys are always asking us for your upgrade windows. Can't happen. Okay, this has to be available 24/7. That part is non-negotiable.
Always on. Got it.
Okay. The third part is, we're not going to do this in the traditional way. Traditionally, we wait for holidays and certain times of year, we roll out big campaigns. We have been able to tell you in the past when the loads were going to increase. Now, I can no longer do that. And I can't do that because we as a company are not going to tell them as our customers when to do stuff. We're going to let them tell us. If we do this application right, they're going to decide when something is a real hit. And when it explodes, it explodes. You've got to be ready to deal with it.
All right.
Okay? So globally distributed, always on, traffic spikes. Let's do it. Can you make that happen?
We can do that.
But thank you.
I also have some other things in addition to your requirements.
Okay.
So we're not investing in our data centers anymore, so I'm going to use some public clouds.
Have at it.
And it's not quite as simple as just pushing out offers to our customers. To make that real, we have to integrate with about 12 of our enterprise systems, and there's a lot to that.
Okay.
But we can do it. So let me show you what we're looking at.
Okay. Let's go see. By the way, I don't particularly get along with some of the GMs in the other lines of business, so good luck with the integration part.
All right, so what we have here is a multi-cloud application, and it's running in three public clouds, AWS, Azure, and GCP. And here you'll see that we have six nodes running in each cloud.
Okay.
All right, so this multi-cloud application is based on a masterless architecture. Building apps is easy. Data is difficult. So in addition to the immense integration we're going to have to do, we're going to have to get data from inventory management systems, our catalog systems, our customer systems, the marketing systems, including the offers, payments, recommendation engine, fraud, you get it. There's a lot to it. But it's not just about data integration. It's about security, scale, and data availability as well. So let's take a look. So in our app, we have three data centers, one in the west, one in the east, and one in northern Europe. Each one of these data centers has six nodes represented by the circles here. Now, the green color around each one of these circles is significant. This is a status indicator telling me that these nodes are up. So you heard that right, folks. These are real machines. Let me show you.
OK, Chelsea, I got to tell you, this is giving me a little bit of a headache because the last time we tried to do this whole different databases in different regions, I don't know why, but I kept hearing the replication was taking forever. So I'm not sure three different databases is the way to go about this.
Well, let me pause you. It's not three different databases. It's a single database across many geographies.
Okay, so you're not telling me I'm going to run into all those long replication problems we had in the past.
It's going to be simple.
Okay.
All right, here
we
go.
You're the boss.
So here's OpsCenter. OpsCenter is our tool that is fantastic because it gives me a single pane of glass view across my entire cluster. So right now, my cluster has three public clouds in it. Each one of these rings is a data center. So here you see that we have AWS, Azure, and GCP. Now, if we look at one of these nodes, you'll see the IP address is within the range of the given provider. And so again, folks, real machines.
So these are actually live right now in those clouds?
Yep, these are our production nodes. Okay. So let's go back and look at this. All right, we're green across the board. Awesome. So we're ready to launch our app. It's 9 o'clock on the East Coast here. Let's go. All right, we're launching our app, and our customers are able to browse our catalog.
Now, see, those are all coming from the AWS. Is that because that's where we are?
Right, so that data center is the closest geographically to us at this moment.
Okay, great app. Nobody's buying anything. So that's a problem.
That is a problem. So let's launch the offers out to our customers.
That's what we want to see over in the GM side of the house. All right.
All right, so we have the reads happening against our database for browsing the catalog. We have the writes for when people are adding items into their shopping carts and making purchases. So, Billy, it's up in production.
Chelsea,
offers are
that
live.
Is beautiful. That's exactly what I was hoping for. Thank you so much for your time.
Whoa, wait a minute. So as much as I love to shake your hand right now,
it's
Billy.
It's running. It's done.
Not all is rainbows and butterflies here. So this is an ideal state. Apps are up, or nodes are up, no big deal. But there's something that we need to take into consideration. Billy, I'm going to pull you into reality.
Okay.
Chaos in the clouds is real. Now, what does that mean? So imagine a massive number of servers out there that are interconnected. Many points for failure. Things go wrong all the time. And in order for our app to be truly successful in production, we have to be resilient to chaos in the clouds. So let me show you what a little bit of that looks like here. So Billy, I'm going to drop one node.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to push this button here. A node's going to drop. Y'all will see that our customers are still able to shop. Here we go. All right, we have one node down here in AWS. Our customers are still shopping. Pretty cool, huh? But let's go bigger. Let's go really big. So, Billy, what if I told you we're going to take down an entire data center of ours, a third of our nodes, and our customers will still be able to shop?
Can I do that?
You want to push the button?
I do.
You guys want to see Billy push the button to kill the data center?
Try and drop the whole data center.
All right.
Which it looks like it's already starting to go red.
All right, so here we go. AWS is down. Our customers are still shopping. You'll notice here in the center, we're no longer reading from AWS because it's not available. It's switched over to reading from Azure. This is a big deal. Our app is resilient to chaos in the clouds.
That's awesome. So Chelsea, let me come out of demo mode for a minute. What we just saw was a very, very real demonstration, obviously. Those are live machines happening right now. One thing I think that's worth noting is we've had the read redundancy for quite some time. That application, the column on the left here, the purchases, those are writes that were happening. Those
correct.
Did not stop, right?
That's
with no intervention, I can assume, on your part or on the application.
This is a big deal. So we designed this to be resilient. And this is what resiliency looks like. It's not enough to just have reads. We need to have the reads and writes for our customers to really be able to shop.
Okay. And I'm assuming you didn't bring down all of Amazon. I'm thinking we'd be getting tweets,
well,
right?
Well, I don't have that kind of power.
Okay. So in your experience, Chelsea was an architect for years for a company. And as I said, now she works with our customers on a regular basis. In your experience, how real of a scenario is this? Because we're thinking sometimes that the cloud might be the answer. We don't need to worry about things like this. And is it the cloud's fault that this happened? And how often does this happen?
So, I mean, remember, this is servers and this is technology. Things go wrong, okay? Nodes can go down. You know, hard drives can die. Network connectivity issues, you name it. And it's really important for apps to be able to withstand that. And they need a database that can intelligently detect when these events are happening and respond accordingly.
So you said a database. In other words, not a lot of application code to make that happen. You want that to happen at the database level.
Correct.
Great. So it sounds to me like you've got a pretty good handle when things go wrong.
We do. We do. But remember, you know, chaos in the clouds is real. But that doesn't mean chaos for me or my team or my company or my customers. We've solved multi-cloud resiliency.
Awesome. Chelsea, thank you so much.
All right. Thanks,
all right.
Billy.